myself Professor Law from Engineering of Engineering and Technology, Honorable Engineering Department. So, we have learned about the subject vehicle dynamics. Particularly in the fourth chapter, we have learned about suspension terminology and suspension geometries. In previous lecture, we have seen several geometry of the suspensions and how that are going to affect my overall suspension performance for our car that we have already seen. So in today's lecture, we will see about spring rate, like what will be my spring rate, how it is going to affect my overall performance of the suspension. Second is the wheel hoe, that is new terminology while we driving drag car or something. So that two points that we are going to cover in this lecture. So let us begin with the first topic, that is spring rate. So what do you mean by spring rate? So we can say that the spring rate is the components in setting the vehicle's ride height or its location. So it is directly or indirectly associated with the stiffness of the suspension, or we can say the stiffness of the spring. Moving further, if we talk about that force applied on that suspension and how that overall length of that particular coil is going to change, that we need to see, and that is the part of the suspension, or we can say the spring rate. Moving further, the change in the force it exerted by the deflection of the spring, that gives the spring rate. So we can say the ultimately the spring rate definition would be spring rate, or the spring constant of the spring is the change in the force it exerts and divided by the deflection of the spring. So that is about the spring rate. Okay, one more thing we need to remember, that the springs are not too hard or too soft, because it doesn't give our effective suspension effects. So we can say that if my suspension spring is too hard or too soft, it is not giving me proper suspension effect, or we can say that it is very ineffective suspension system. Moving further, we need to choose wisely or according to our vehicle's requirement, like how suspension is going to be there and how the spring rate is going to affect. So you cannot put different vehicles suspension in other vehicles. So we can say that if the 2000 pound racing car is there, so you cannot apply 10,000 pound trucks suspension system in my particular car. So we can say that in our luxury car or passenger car, we have soft spring rate. So for that we need so it gives us comfortable and smooth ride while driving. So this is about spring rate. Let us discuss about the general formula of the spring rate. Here you can see that the compression of spring is given. So here you can see that one is the compressed spring and another one is uncompressed spring. Then I am applying 10 pound of force to the spring. What will happen? The spring is going to compress by 2 inches. So in formula you can see that K is equal to F by X, where F is the force. So we have to say that the 10 pound is the force, X is the 2 inch, that is the compression of the spring. So either compression or expansion that you can take. So overall spring rate would be 5 pound force per inch. So that is about my spring rate. So it is either by compression or by expansion of the spring. Moving further, let's talk about the general drag race. So we have seen many races, and among these races you will find such races that is called drag races. We all know that the drag races, or these cars are having larger amount of power and need more power in such a small amount of time interval to win the race. So for that, what we have to keep in our mind, first is the power of the engine. We should maximize the power of engine by using several components in engine, or also by using maximum amount of CC in our engine, so that how we can produce more power. And the main and ultimate aim is to transmit this power to the road or to the wheels, and that wheel is going to fully utilize that power with respect to that road condition. One more example about the drag race is here. Like if I'm going to accelerate my vehicle, what will happen? The tire is going to roll at that particular point. So ultimately we can say that the tire and road that are not having enough contact or enough friction to get my vehicle moved. So in that case, we need to think over that how my these power are going to affect my overall riding. So for that, the wheel hook term is there. So here you can see that one car that is about going to start. And if I'm going to apply that maximum force to the wheel, what will happen? The wheel is going to wobble. We can say that it is initially moved up and down movement. So particularly that movement is called wheel hook. And with the wheel hook condition, you cannot fully utilize that maximum power to the wheel, or you cannot accelerate that much power from your car. So let us see technically that how really wheel hook is going to affect. So first we can say that the maximum power from the engine as possible we have to transmit that to the ground. Secondly, successful drag car is that the total power is going to utilize by the wheel, or we can say that, and that will give maximum acceleration, or we can say that the actual acceleration that road drag. To fulfill this requirement, what we need, we have to use such suspension system that cannot affect or that cannot create that wheel hook, or we need to use that much that tire that is not going to decelerate or not lose that power with the road condition. So ultimately I need to see my suspension first. Okay. Without changing its suspension system, it is not possible to eliminate that wheel hook from my drag race car. Finally, we need to conclude that from several changes, we will find or we can eliminate this wheel hook condition from our vehicle. So let us see that first. Like there are several questions how wheel hook is going to be there. First is the traction issue. So the traction issue applies when the tire condition is not proper, when the road condition is not proper, and after that is come suspension is going to come in our picture, like the bushing. If the bushing of the wheel is not proper or it can damage or is not well designed, so these are the possibilities that can create the wheel hook. Moving further, as I said already, the road condition or the road surface that is going to affect my overall wheel hook condition. Moving further, dealing with wheel hook, how we can eliminate this function, and we can create or we can produce or we can transfer more power to the road surface in drag race. So first step is to identify the cause, like what are the problems, is it in my tire or in suspension system or road condition or bushings. So first of all we need to see that where the problem comes from. The second is upgrading this part. If I am finding such an issue, like bushing is not well, we have to change that bushing. So we need to upgrade particular that part for eliminate this wheel hook effect. Another one, if the whole okay is there, so what we need to do, we need to change my suspension system, or according to that condition we need to select particular that suspension system that is very helpful and to eliminate my wheel hook condition. And finally we need to see that if the tire condition is proper or not. So these are the major points that we need to keep in our mind to eliminate wheel hook. So that is all about today's lecture. We have learned spring rate that is due to compression or extraction of that spring, and that is very helpful for our vehicle. Like if I need to comfortable ride, then my suspension spring should be proper, not too stiff, not too smooth. So this, that is first. The second topic is about VHOCE, that is undesirable characteristics for our vehicle. So these are the several points how VHOCE is going to be there, how we need to eliminate this thing. Okay, so that is all about this. Thank you.